We are under lockdown.
The curfew applies to the entire territory.
President Muhammadu Buhari has ordered a lockdown in Abuja, Lagos and Ogun for the next 14 days.
Hi, my name is Georgie Ndirangu. I'm a BBC Africa journalist and I'm here to talk about two things. How lockdowns are being implemented across Africa, and then we'll look at the potential impact of lockdowns on some of the continent's economies. The fight against the deadly COVID-19 has risen a notch higher across Africa. COVID-19 is fast spreading across the continent and the stakes are getting higher. The number of infections is in its thousands and the number of deaths is increasing day by day. Like many countries across the globe, African countries are using lockdowns as a tool to slow down the spread. But the challenge many African governments are facing is twofold. On one hand, how lockdowns are implemented and received by the people. And on the other hand, what happens to the economy if the majority of people are told to stay at home? Countries like Nigeria, South Africa, Rwanda, Uganda, Mali, Kenya, and Zimbabwe have so far imposed varied lockdown measures.
There are about four types of lockdowns. This is limited to time, and this in Kenya has been happening between 7 p.m. and 5 a.m. daily. In South Africa, they're experiencing something called total lockdown. They cannot completely move. They are on a total lockdown. This is where the different parts of the country are going to be experiencing lockdown. Finally, there's what Japan is experiencing, which is called emergency. It's also complete lockdown, but it comes with very severe consequences if you break it.
Although in many African cities, curfews, lockdowns, and social distancing are being observed, in other areas, the response has largely been negative. In Kenya and South Africa, citizens have clashed with security forces over lockdown measures. Several people have died in both countries. But of course, there has been a lot of challenges. For example, how can a lockdown be implemented in informal settlements like Kibera in Nairobi, Kenya, or Alexandra in Johannesburg, South Africa, where often six people live in one room?
When people run to rural areas feeling locked down, the first impact is, of course, related to the high possibility of bringing the virus to the rural area, thus increasing the cases and also places where the government has to intervene in terms of health services.
In Uganda, market traders will not be allowed to go back home during the lockdown period and will have to make arrangements to live close to their stores.
Africa has the highest level of informal employment, and when you put a lockdown, you're basically taking food out of the mouth of people. And this is the biggest challenge we're facing.
Now, let's look at the potential impact of lockdowns on African economies. Many economies were struggling even before the crisis. Take South Africa and Nigeria, for example. In Nigeria, the economy had been reeling from a drop in global oil prices, while South Africa was already going through a recession. You see, Africa has an enormous disparity between the rich and the poor. The working class work in insecure, low pay and unprotected conditions. And despite that, many just cannot afford not to work. Due to lockdown measures, many people are not allowed to go to work apart from essential workers. Closure of factories abroad and Africa has disrupted supply chains, trade, travel, putting enormous pressure on economies.
First of all, we need to increase liquidity so that people can spend. If people cannot spend, if people cannot buy stuff, demand is reduced, then production will go down. And that is going to be, it's not just be a recession, it's going to lead to a depression.
Clearly, countries across Africa are facing a tough challenge in protecting its citizens and their fragile economies. But it is the type of measures and how they are implemented that will determine how the countries come out after the pandemic.